दार्जिलिङ हिमालयन रेलवेले विश्व विरासतको दर्जा पाएको 20 वर्ष पूर्तिको महिनाव्यापी कार्यक्रम आज सम्पन्न गर्यो। यस अवसरमा आज बिहान स्थानीय रेलवे स्टेशनबाट एक विशेष ट्रेन चलाएको थियो भने त्यसका स्थानीय कलाकारहरूले सांस्कृतिक नृत्य पनि प्रस्तुत गरेका थिए। त्यसपछि स्थानीय चौरस्तामा आयोजना गरिएको एक कार्यक्रमलाई सम्बोधन गर्दै पूर्वोत्तर रेलवेका महाप्रबन्धक सञ्जीव राईले विगत 5 वर्ष अघिको तुलनामा दार्जिलिङ हिमालयन रेलवेको माग वा यात्री संख्या दोब्बर बढेको बताए।
पंजाब सिंधु गुजरात मराठा काबिर उत्कल बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उचल जलधि तरंगा तब शुभ नामे जागे तब शुभ आशीष मागे गाए तब जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे।
दर्जा प्राप्त गरेको दिन र आज यसले 20 वर्ष अर्थात् 2 decades पुरा गरिसकेको छ।
इन्फर्मेसन सर्भिस गोर्खाल्यान्ड टेरिटोरियल एडमिनिस्ट्रेसन एन्ड अल अदर
Now it's time to release the coffee table book on DHR Darjeeling Himalayan Railway.
Anniversary of the inscription of Darjeeling Himalayan Railway as a World Heritage Site. I'm happy to be here with my colleague Mr. Sanjeev Roy, General Manager, Northeast Frontier Railway, Mr. Pradhan, our Secretary of the Gorkha Territorial Administration, and our Divisional Railway Manager, Katiyar, whose jurisdiction is the Darjeeling Railway. So this is the 20th year of World Heritage inscription. And as you are aware that back in 1998, this railway was lying shut down because it had landslides on several locations. All the trains, even Ghum station, the roof had been blown off. And it was expected that it is going to be dead, there's no chance. But then the people of Darjeeling, the Indian Railways, the Northeast Frontier Railway, the Katihar Division, they brought it back to life. And even before we brought it back to life in 1999, recognizing its most outstanding features, in December, 20 years ago exactly, on the 5th of December, it was given World Heritage inscription. And this became the first cultural World Heritage inscription in this part of the country, including its state and the area. As you are aware, the inscription says that this is the first example in the world, the first. And it also says it is still the most outstanding example in the world. So the Darjeeling Railway is the first and still most outstanding. And unfortunately for us and for everybody, this the people and the railway, they are very intertwined with each other. It's a very symbiotic relationship. And this relationship has come about ever since the area of Darjeeling and the railway got established about 140 years ago. This is continuing, and that has also been made it possible to bring about this revival. After the World Heritage inscription, if you remember, we were here in Chaurasta in November 2000. When the railway was fully restored, almost Herculean efforts were put in by the Indian Railways and especially the Northeast Frontier Railway, and the set of engineers, which was considered impossible engineering, the entire track was restored up to Darjeeling. Over Pagla Jhora, almost 7 new bridges were constructed. Several kilometers of track near Pagla Jhora had to be revived. The Ghum station was brought back to life. The Ghum Museum was established, and while we were gathered here 20 years ago in this holy place, Kanchenjunga was smiling, and I'm happy that today again it's smiling its blessings on us 20 years on. And you'll be very happy to note that while we are marking its 20th anniversary, in my last 1 year in the Railway Board and the last 1 year with the very dynamic efforts of our General Manager, Northeast Frontier Railway, this railway has, you know, achieved greater heights. Like we've almost doubled our passenger numbers within 1 year. And the steam engines, as many as 13 steam engines are still working. And these steam engines today, you saw 795, which is a made in India, made in Tindharia locomotive. And today it's in steam. It's brought a train to Darjeeling today. It's completing 100 years this year. So it's a very, very proud moment. And now we have efforts to, you know, further improve its beauty. And overall, let me say that while Darjeeling has many, many reasons for people to come to Darjeeling, you know, it's an exhilarating, enchanting, charming place like no other. Darjeeling has its mountaineering institute, it has the holy Kanchenjunga, it has the red pandas, and has these beautiful landscapes. Darjeeling has the tea, which is the finest in the world, you know, in Japan, Germany, etc. They drink nothing but Darjeeling tea. But the Darjeeling Railway is nowhere else in the world. I mean, this is the first and still most outstanding. So this is absolutely special. The potential is huge. And while we work together with the Gorkha Territorial Administration, let me tell you that even the tourists who want to spend $1,000 a day, they are attracted to Darjeeling. Even if those who are spending to spend $1,000 a day, they are attracted to Darjeeling. So that's the kind of, you know, value that this adds. And World Heritage Sites, you know, the world over, they become billion-dollar examples for the people. Essentially, it brings in development and for the people. So I believe that while the railway is making all efforts to, you know, keep the railway functioning, and that's a huge challenge. It's done nowhere else in the world. All other parts of the world, you may have 10 kilometers of railway, you may have a steam engine or two. But this is 90 kilometers. It's not a toy train, it's a full railway. It's a living railway. It's a grandfather railway. So the railway is going out of its way to keep the thing. But we would like to encourage the territorial administration and the community that some of the other spin-offs that are there, for example, there has to be, you know, proper buffer zone management across the length of the railway. Because from the railway right up to the Kanchenjunga is something like there is nowhere else in the world. So you've got to preserve those landscapes, you've got to protect these buffer zones, we've got to protect these extended buffer zones and help in the conservation and the landscape right through the length of the railway. And we would also like to say that all efforts should be made to promote tourism, responsible tourism. We also, through UNESCO, had started many endogenous tourism programs. And endogenous tourism means then the people are associated with those tourism programs. So tourism has to be started in a big way. And then the third is the infrastructure development. Because as you know, these tourists come and as the pressures build up, the whole thing should not crumble. So that infrastructure development, that has to be, you know, done by the government of India, the state government, the territorial administration. That's going to be absolutely critical. And in the overall context, the environment of the area, that needs to be thoroughly protected. So the railway will take efforts to take care of the railway. But the other aspects pertaining to, you know, buffer zones, pertaining to tourism, pertaining to environment, pertaining to infrastructure development, those areas will naturally have to go hand in hand. And in the overall context, Darjeeling, of course, benefits in a huge way. The people of Darjeeling, as I always say, the ever-smiling people of Darjeeling, you know, that spirited people of Darjeeling, they definitely benefit. The state benefits, the country benefits, and it's for the benefit of the whole world. It's for the benefit of posterity, for the future generations, because we've enjoyed this heritage for the last few generations. Several more generations, as Mr. Pradhan from the Gorkha Territorial Administration was saying, it has only survived 140 years or so. For the 21st century, for the 22nd century, and for the 23rd century, may it be a joy forever. So, thank you.
What about this comprehensive management? When will it be ready by?
The conservation management.
No, the comprehensive management plan.
This is a separate exercise being done by UNESCO.
Till when will it be ready?
See, we have already got a management plan. We already have a management authority. We have a director DHR. And the railway is being kept functioning. It could not have been kept functioning because if it did not have a management. We have a complete comprehensive management. This comprehensive management has been presented to UNESCO as part of its inscription process. They constantly, through their own experts, they appoint bodies to, you know, build upon that. So they are building upon it. We were expecting it to have been ready more than a year back. They have still not got it ready. Whatever be it, it is finally our responsibility to do. It's our heritage, our posterity, our this thing. They will be giving their views. We have not received them till today, but that's going to be a separate exercise. I think we must empower the Northeast Frontier Railway and the Gorkha Territorial Administration to take its best efforts to take the railway forward. And sometimes, you know, heritage cannot be sanitized. So it's a symbiotic thing which goes together. So it will continue to go together. As and when they present their documents, we can have a look at that. But for the present, let me assure you that if the management was not strong, you would not have seen the 795 today, and you would not see the Tindharia.
One last question. We have frequently seen that there's a fight between the coal contractors and the coal workers, due to which the steam engine gets closed. So any...
Yeah, recently also it was more than 25 days.
Yeah, it happened. There was some misunderstanding and disputes between
how do you plan
we sounded the contract and that has been...
it happens very frequently. It happened in 2018.
No,
it happened in 2018. Whenever a new contractor comes.
Any new contract, once he starts a solution, there can be something like that. So we have been told that that has been taken care of and hopefully
there
will not
be there be a backup plan? Because 20 days of the DHR steam not running during this UNESCO celebration and commemoration.
We are working on that. We'll be building up that thing so that that discontinuation of steam loco doesn't take place.
We should do that.
That's okay. We'll be having a buffer stock for that.